Hello everyone, I hope you are all doing great. In today's video, we'll be taking a look at two vintage calculators from the 1970s. The first one is the Casio Personal M1, which features a VFD or vacuum fluorescent display. The second is the Texas Instruments TI-30 scientific calculator, which has an LED display. Both of these are from an era before LCDs, that is, liquid crystal displays, became the norm. So, let's get started. First, let's examine the Casio Personal M1 version H813P. It has a power switch located on the side. The green dot indicates that the calculator is powered on. Runs on two AA batteries providing 3 volts. It also has the option to be powered by a power adapter. This pocket calculator was made in Japan by Casio in 1976. It has 21 keys and can display up to 8 digits for positive numbers. For negative numbers, it uses 7 digits, with the first digit display reserved for the minus sign. The highlight of this model is its captivating vacuum fluorescent display, which, as we see, can be influenced by magnetic fields. It looks stunning in the dark, though unfortunately the keys are not backlit. Only if it had that feature. Now, let's take a closer look at the second calculator, the TI-30. Scientific calculator. Notice the rectangular slot on the side. This was intended for charging if a rechargeable battery was used. However, this uses an ordinary 9-volt battery introduced by Texas Instruments as a cost-saving option. The TI-30 was launched by Texas Instruments in 1976 and assembled in the United States. It supports basic scientific functions such as trigonometry, logarithms, exponents, and their inverses. It can display 8 digits for both positive and negative integers, and for larger or smaller numbers, it uses exponents. A key feature of this calculator is its bright red LED display, which also looks great in the dark, though again no illuminated keys. Here you can see the calculator in power saving mode, where it only shows the running dots. Now let's do some precision tests, comparing these vintage models with the modern Casio FX-991ES Plus scientific calculator. First, we'll take the square root of 2 and then square the result. The Casio Personal M1 is not able to return exactly 2 due to its limited precision. No such issue with the modern calculator. Next, we'll take the inverse of 9 and multiply the result by 9. Again, the Casio M1 shows its precision limitation. Let's see how the TI-30 performs. This one has no problem recovering 2 after squaring the square root. It even handles squaring and square rooting 4 times correctly. However, it struggles when taking the square root 5 times. That is, calculating 2 to the power 1 by 32. If we directly raise 2 to the power 1 by 32 and then apply power 32 on the answer, the result is slightly better, with the last decimal digit showing 9 instead of the earlier 8. The modern calculator, of course, handles this perfectly without any loss of precision. Finally, let's try the forbidden operation, division by zero. The Casio Personal M1 shows E for error. The TI-30 explicitly displays error. And the modern calculator gives math error. Despite the limited precision and features of these vintage calculators, they still carry a certain charm, reminding us of how far technology has evolved.